Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast. Office, Excel 2013 preview, Excel 2013 for rookies. Hey, welcome back. It's Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. I said all week we'd be taking a look at some of the new features in Excel 2013. And so first I'm going to come here and go to recent files. All right, hey, big difference now. We have a list of recent workbooks. We have a computer, which gets me my recent folders. But we have the SkyDrive now. So remember, we assign in. So it's very easy to open things from all three. Now, it irritates me just a tiny bit that I have to click computer and then zip 102 or AAA to get to my folder. I used to be able to click the folder right away. I love that feature in 2010, and they made it one click further away. But hey, I'm not gonna complain about that. Well, I am. I just did, but I can live with it, right? All right. So features for people who are completely new to Excel. This is an example I use all the time. We want to join first name and last name over in column D, and I always make fun of the people who start to type. Right, rather than use equal proper open parenthesis A2 ampersand quote space quote ampersand B2 close paren, I make fun of those people. Oh my gosh, this is absolutely amazing. Watch when someone sits down and starts doing something really, really bad. It lets you do the first one as soon as I type the P in Paul. Look, can you see it? They say, hey, we think this is what you want to do. I just press enter. The whole thing is done. Is that amazing or what? It's called flash fill. And they don't put formulas there. They actually just they put the actual text. And so if I would just come through here and do Thomas S like that, right? They get the first one. Paul M. They figured it out. Bam, right down the line. It's pretty wild. And also, if you're splitting text apart, the example that they gave is movies and genre all in one cell, and you start typing the movie, and it has amazing heuristics here that will get it right. And if there's a few that it doesn't get right, like down here, Conrad, if I retype L period, it'll go through and look for others that had a similar problem and fix those as well. All right, so great feature for people who are new to Excel. Here's another one. Here's a big model. There's a bunch of formulas in this model. When I change this rent number, a lot of other things in the worksheet will change. But before, it happened so fast, you couldn't really tell. Now they do something called slot machining. So I'm going to type 3600 here. And don't watch the 3600. Watch the other cells. And you're going to see them actually animate in. They only do this on the first screen full of data. They don't do all million rows. But just the things you can see. So that way you can say, hey, there's things changing when I change that number. All right, I want to click in 3, 2, 1, now. Did you see it? Boy, I hope the frame rate caught that. I saw a whole bunch of cells change down here and so on. Really, really cool that is there as a visual clue for people who are new to Excel. Another thing that they added for us, for people who are new to Excel, is people don't know how to do any data analysis. You know, when you say to someone, oh, hey, do a pivot table. They're like, oh, no, I don't want to do a pivot table. That sounds too scary to me. All right, so the quick analysis lens down here is offering formatting, charts, totals, tables, and spark lines. All right, so it pops up. Let's do a color scale. Oh, wow, that looks good. Or maybe an icon set. Look how cool that is. Or highlight the top 10%. Totals. We want to add a sum total to the bottom. Or you scroll over here, the good ones over here. The sum total to the right-hand side. And you can see what it's going to look like before you do it. Charts. They have some recommended charts. So here's a clustered column chart. Do you want that? Or do you want that? Or do you want that? Or do you want that? What's that? Ooh. Right. Tables, what's up here? It's only offering me a blank pivot table. I guess it doesn't have enough data. Let me come out and try this again here. We'll select all this data, control asterisk, and try the data lens. Go to tables. There we go. Okay, so here there are going to be selected pivot tables, and you can see a little picture of each one before you do it. Is that wild? So there, a summary of revenue by product, summary of profit, revenue, and quantity by product, Summary of profit by region. Is this wild? You don't have to know anything. Just open the drop down and choose it, and bam, you get a pivot table. These features are fabulous for people who are new to Excel. Again, the Don't Fear the Spreadsheet crowd, Tyler and all of her friends are going to love these new features in Excel. Hey, but don't despair. There's plenty of good stuff for the Excel pros, and we'll take a look at that tomorrow. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. Oh, they're not doing it for us. All right, back here, insert recommended pivot tables. Awesome.